What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel, and welcome to another Pokemon Sword and Shield VGC 2021 Series 10 video. Today, I'm going to be talking about this Necrozma Dusk main team that I'm going to be giving you guys a rental code for. Of course, that code is up on the screen right now. But before we get into the breakdown, do me a favor, if you guys enjoyed this video at any point in time, leave a like on it, subscribe to the channel, and turn on notifications because I bring you daily Pokemon VGC content. Answer my comment question of the day. Between Necrozma Duskmane and Necrozma Dawn Wings, which one have you been using more this season? I'm definitely more of a Duskmane fan. I don't really see much of a way for Dawn Wings to be that viable. And I know a lot of people will say, like, Duskmane isn't really that great. It loses to a lot of common stuff. I personally made this team specifically to use my favorite restricted, which is Necrozma Duskmane, and a couple of other fan favorites of the channel, you know, so yeah. Anyways, let's go ahead and get into it. Let's shoot for 200 likes, and yeah. So, before I even talk about this, I'm just going to say this straight up. This is completely unscripted. I have a couple of notes next to me. It is like 11 p.m. right now, and I'm usually in bed by 10 since I wake up at like 5 to go to the gym. So I'm very tired. So this is just going to be one take. If I fumble my words, whatever. Let's talk about it. So first up, I have, I guess we should talk about the team as a whole. We of course have Necrozma Duskmane, Tapu Bulu, Incineroar, Politoed Kingdra, and Galarian Zapdos. Now on paper, this might look like, hey, this is kind of a wacky team, I kind of see where you're going with it, but how viable could it really be? Well, here's a screenshot of how I was actually doing with the team. I have only played with this team this season. At the time that I'm recording this, I'm like 16-3 and I'm almost like top 500. So yeah, it's a pretty good win record, but I suppose we should talk about the team now. What exactly does it do? How would you lead off with this team? How are you going to play it? So, going through the individual team members first, we have a Necrozma Duskmane with a Mental Herb, Prison Armor, of course, as the only ability it gets. We have Photon Geyser, Sunsteel Strike, Trick Room, and Swords Dance. It's got 252 HP, 108 attack, and 148 special defense with a Brave Nature and zero speed IVs. That was a pain to get. Please, you know, thank me. I'm a hero for hunting for this thing. This thing sucked. But yeah, we have the zero speed IV Necrozma here. Basically, Necrozma is a Pokemon that's very susceptible to losing to things like Intimidate Incineroar, even Intimidate Lando. Regular base Landorus is going to be really annoying to deal with. This Necrozma can of course eat a hit from Life Orb, Timid Landorus because of Prison Armor and the heavy amount of special defense investment I gave it. But yeah, it loses to a lot of stuff like that are common, like Intimidate, Calyrex Shadow Rider, etc. So this entire team is specifically built to compensate for those weaknesses, and once you have those weaknesses locked down or eliminated via other Pokemon on the team, this thing can just absolutely annihilate teams. It walls so many important Pokemon in the metagame, it can take so many crazy hits, and it deals a ton of damage because of that base 157 attack with high base power moves like Sunsteel Strike and Photon Geyser. Now, some people asked, Marcos, why not run Psychic Fangs over Photon Geyser? And my specific reason is, while Psychic Fangs is a pretty good utility move with a decently high base power, Photon Geyser is much more useful in my case because when facing down Pokemon like Volcarona or Rocky Helmet users, etc., Flame Body Pokemon, I'd rather not make contact with them, and Photon Geyser doesn't make contact, so it's just a useful move. And also the extra power over Psychic Fangs is just super useful. Just 100 base power on Photon Geyser is really nice, where Psychic Fangs is 85 base power. So it's a pretty huge difference, and I'm willing to make the trade in PP for that. So yeah, this guy is mainly going to be our Trick Room setter. It's EV'd in a way where it can easily take a modest Water Spout from Kyogre in the rain. And if you're facing off against Kyogre plus Tornadus, a lot of the time the Tornadus will either taunt the Incineroar, or not the Incineroar, the Necrozma Duskmane, or they'll just attempt to one-shot it with a Water Spout. But even if they go for the taunt plus Water Spout, neither of those are going to stop the Trick Room barring a crit, so you're pretty much good to go. You're always going to get Trick Room off versus that lead. Speaking of Kyogre Tornadus, one of the best Pokemon that we have on this team for helping out with that is going to be Tapu Bulu. Now in the comments, a lot of people are going to say, Tapu Bulu not viable, Tapu Bulu bad, why not use Rillaboom, Grassy Glide, Fake Out, ooh, ooh, Monkey Gang, like, you know, standard monkey comments. And I'm a big fan of monkeys too. I love myself some monkey memes. I have that video of the gorilla spinning for 10 hours bookmarked on my YouTube tab, you know. But Tapu Bulu hasn't lost 100% of its viability, and specifically on this team, it has a very, very good niche, and honestly, if I ran Rillaboom, the team wouldn't be working as well. Let me explain. So this Tapu Bulu is running an Assault Vest set with Nature's Madness, Horn Leech, Close Combat, and Snarl. We have 172 HP, 116 attack with a Brave Nature, 68 defense, 4 special attack, and 148 special defense with 0 speed IVs. Now, that 0 speed IVs is super important for two things. First of all, if you're facing off against an Indeedee, which is the most common terrain setter that is slow, you're gonna always get your terrain versus it, where Rillaboom would have to run like 0 speed IVs for a chance to get your terrain up second. So versus Indeedee, if you lead off with your Tapu Bulu, you're gonna get terrain dominance, and it's gonna be very useful for not having to take things like expanding force or having your fake outs blocked. So that's really nice. On top of that, this thing, its actual speed stat ends up being 72, where Necrozma Dust Mane's actual speed stat ends up being 73. So in a lot of situations, what you're going to want to do is actually go for a Trick Room with your Dust Mane Necrozma, let Tapu Bulu just get on the field, and then on the next turn, if you're facing off against something like a Zacian, you can go from the Nature's Madness into the Zacian, cutting its health in half, thus allowing for Necrozma Dust Mane to pick up the KO pretty much every time. It's like 52% minimum on Sunsteel Strike from Necrozma onto a Zacian. So unless they're running like a decent amount of bulk, they're never going to take that at half. A lot of other Pokemon don't like the combination. Nature's Madness plus Photon Geyser is a really solid combination for taking out a lot of Pokemon. So yeah, Tapu Bulu is really nice. It also improves the Calyrex Shadow Rider matchup, which we'll get into later on. Next up on the team, we have the Incineroar. We have just standard Incineroar. There's not much to go over here. Fake Out, Parting Shot, Flare Blitz, Snarl, Safety Goggles is super important for Trick Room teams, especially with Incineroar, because it helps you deal with opposing Amoongus, which can be pretty problematic for Trick Room modes. The remainder of the team, we have gone over like our three slow Pokemon. We're gonna go over like the three faster Pokemon, which actually really, really help out Dustmane Necrozma in every facet of what makes it bad. We have a rain mode with Politoed and Kingdra. I actually made a whole video talking about Politoed Kingdra the other day if you wanna check that out. Politoed is going to be running a very specially defensive set with a Citrus Berry, Drizzle, Haze, Protect, Scald, Helping Hand, 180 HP, 92 defense, 236 special defense with a Calm Nature. This guy's going to be able to take a +2 Timid Moonblast from Xerneas and haze that away if need be. It's usually not a common thing you have to do, but also it's able to switch it on things like Calyrex Shadow Rider and, you know, prevent it from spiraling out of control by hazing away its stat boosts if that's from like Grimnay. So yeah. Most of the time, it's mainly there to just set up the weather, which helps out a lot of the team defensively. Necrozma and Tapu Bulu also obviously have that fire weakness. Because they're so specially defensive, with the rain up, things like Torkoal aren't really an issue for the team. You can just make sure that if you're facing off against like a Torkoal team or like Torkoal Calyrex, which is something that you tend to see with Calyrex Ice Raider, you pretty much always want to bring the Politoed to that matchup because it lets you get rid of that sun, and it also just generally makes Kingdra super, super viable, and it, you know, you can use it in other situations for stopping Groudon from being able to tank hits in the sun so well. So yeah. Next up, we have Kingdra, which is going to be the main offensive Pokemon on the fast mode. We're going to be running a Life Orb, Swift Swim, Standard Set, just 252, 252, Muddy Water, Draco Meteor, Hurricane Protect, Timid, because if you're running Modest, you won't outspeed Timid Regieleki. And this thing is going to be really, really powerful. In a lot of situations, you're going to get Zacian down to like 60, 70% health, in which case a Helping Hand and Muddy Water will KO in the rain. And that's really helpful since you're going to be naturally outspeeding that thing. It's also doing decent damage to Assault Vest Rillaboom, despite it being Assault Vested. A Helping Handed Hurricane is going to be doing upwards of 80% to that thing. So yeah, a very powerful Pokemon. Draco Meteor is usually not what you're going to want to click with this thing. It's mainly just going to be Muddy Water spam. And the reason this Pokemon is so integral to this team's success is the two Pokemon that Necrozma Dust Mane hates facing the most are Landorus Incarnate and Incineroar. And if you have a Politoed Kingdra lead versus Landorus Incarnate and Incineroar, and you don't miss your Muddy Water, you pretty much get rid of the two most annoying Pokemon for Necrozma Dust Mane to deal with. And at that point, Necrozma Dust Mane has almost nothing left in the field that can stand in its way. Zacian does negligible damage to that thing if you intimidate it once, and Rillaboom is typically the last Pokemon you'll see on like a Landorus Incineroar Zacian team. Like, it's going to be Rillaboom, which gets hardwalled by Necrozma Dust Mane. I think you actually end up healing more from Rillaboom's grassy terrain than you take damage from it. And the last Pokemon on the team is going to be the Galarian Zapdos, which Galarian Zapdos takes the Xerneas matchup from usually winning to, oh my god, if you lose, you did something terribly wrong. And here's why. Like I said, this team is mainly meant to stuff and absolutely get rid of the main issues that Necrozma Dust Mane doesn't want to deal with. And the poster child of the I Hate Necrozma fan club is going to be Incineroar. Incineroar absolutely hates Galarian Zapdos. You're able to protect on the fake out, and at that point, you've already gotten the Defiant boost from the Intimidate, and you're able to click Close Combat onto anything you want. Incineroar almost never runs Protect, so they're going to have a Ghost type or something in the back to eat that hit, because nothing, and I mean nothing, like sticking plus one Close Combat from Galarian Zapdos. Taunt is great for stopping opposing Trick Room, or if you anticipate your Pokemon or your opponent might be going for like a Sleep Powder with their Focus Sash Venusaur, you can actually go for the Taunt over the Brave Bird to ensure they don't get anything off. It's also very useful versus the Amoongus matchup, since a lot of Amoongus aren't actually running Mental Orb right now. They're usually like a Berry or a Focus Sash. So being able to stop that in its track is really nice, because a lot of Amoongus would be like, yeah, I'm Focus Sash, I can take the Brave Bird, so I'll just go for the Spore. Taunt is just much safer in that situation, and it makes it a really cool Pokemon to just, you know, have on lead. The reason I'm running Brave Bird over Dual Wingbeat, which I got that as a question the other day, why are you running Brave Bird in a Focus Sash Galarian Zapdos? That's mainly because Dual Wingbeat has really, really low power compared to Brave Bird. It's literally 50% less, since it's 80 base power in total and Brave Bird's 120. So it's like 50% less. Is that the right way of saying it? Brave Bird has 50% more power than Dual Wingbeat, because it's 120-80. Yeah, that's the right way to say it. Even though I'm Focus Sash, and that would break the Focus Sash, the majority of the time, it's worth it. If I'm going to Protect on the Rillaboom, it's probably going to Grassy Glide me the next turn anyways, try to pick up some chip damage and break my Sash. So Brave Bird is inconsequential in that situation. And versus things like Regieleki, you're going second anyways, so you can go ahead and take the Electrode, take the Volt Switch, and just click Close Combat, so it wouldn't really matter. Your Sash is already broken at that point. The extra power is 100% worth it, in my opinion. So let's talk about how this team plays versus common cores that you're going to see in the metagame. I guess we'll start off with Zacian. Versus Zacian, your main deal is if they have Landorus plus Incineroar, pretty much always lead off with your own Incineroar in the Kingdra, and you can switch out the Politoed if you don't anticipate them going for like a fake out or anything, and just get the rain up and go for your Muddy Water and get like a double KO on those Pokemon. Also, you know, you're already outspeeding Pokemon like Magnet Regieleki, which will allow you to get the clean KO with a Muddy Water. And at that point, when you have Incineroar plus Kingdra and Politoed on the team, you're able to deal with a lot of the problem Pokemon for Necrozma Dust Mane, allowing you to just bring the Necrozma Dust Mane in the back to just win, pretty much. Like, as soon as you get rid of Incineroar or Landorus on the opposing team, Necrozma Dust Mane is pretty set to Swords Dance and Sweep under Trick Room, if not just attack outright. Versus the Xerneas matchup, this is the most free matchup of all time. They tend to bring a Volcarona or an Incineroar or even both to the match to ensure that Xerneas is able to set up safely. You can always lead off Necrozma plus Galarian Zapdos, and neither one of those supports beats that lead, because if they end up leading off Xerneas plus Incineroar, guess what? Now you have plus one on your Zapdos, and you can go for typically they're going to go ahead and go for like the fake out on the Necrozma Dust Mane there to stop you from Sunseal striking. So you have the option of either going for a Taunt on the Xerneas and holding onto your Focus Sash to stop them from setting up at all, while also still going for the Sunseal strike into them or the Trick Room, you know, either one that'll set you up in the better position depending on how the, you know, the board looks. Or you can just go for like the Close Combat plus Sunseal Strike into the Incineroar and the Xerneas respectively to just get two clean KOs. Versus the Volcarona lead, that one's even more funny because they didn't even intimidate you. You just Trick Room and Brave Bird and you're good. Like, you just win. Volcarona and Incineroar both get stuffed by Galarian Zapdos. In the back, you bring the Tapu Bulu every time because it allows you to beat the Urshifu Rapid Strike, which is common on Xerneas teams. And it also is just really nice for snarling a Xerneas who might have been able to get a stray Geomancy off, and it walls Xerneas pretty well. It's able to eat that hit very, very effectively. You're guaranteed to get a 2-hit KO, and Horn Leech I think possibly makes it a 3-hit KO, which is kind of cool. I forgot about that calc, so yeah. Generally for that matchup, it's going to be Necrozma and Incineroar on lead, Tapu Bulu, and either, or not Necrozma and Incineroar, it's going to be Necrozma, Zapdos on lead with Tapu Bulu and Incineroar in the back. So yeah. Versus Calyrex Shadow Rider, this one a lot of you might think is a very problematic matchup, and the Tapu Bulu solves everything about that, and that's the fun part. So versus Calyrex Shadow Rider, what you're going to want to do is you have to examine the team. Typically, if you see a Calyrex Shadow Rider, it's either going to be running an Indeedee or a Mian Shao, but not really both, as a support Pokemon. The main reason is Mian Shao sort of blocks, or Mian Shao gets blocked by Psychic Terrain if it wants to go for a Fake Out, so they have sort of not a very synergistic combo going there, but you know, it's one or the other. When you're facing off versus that, it's super free. They're going to lead off Calyrex Shadow Rider like 99% of the time because they see that you have an Akrazo Dust main, and they can lead off Mian Shao plus Calyrex and feel safe versus that because they're able to one-shot the Incineroar, the close combat. To that, I say, go ahead and just lead off Tapu Bulu plus Necrozma Dust main, and they're going to be so flustered. They're going to want to go for the Fake Out onto the Necrozma to prevent any kind of Trick Room shenanigans, or maybe if it's able to live the hit. So what you can actually do is go ahead and click a Snarl on the Calyrex plus Mian Shao lead, thus breaking the sash on the Mian Shao and also dealing major damage to Calyrex and lowering its special attack, while you actually switch out your Necrozma for the Incineroar on that turn, taking pretty much no damage. At that point, what you can actually do is double out your Incineroar for the Necrozma Dust main, go for the Horn Leech onto the Mian Shao, getting a KO and pretty much all of your health back. And then from that point on, you've gotten rid of the one thing that beats Incineroar on their team, and then you just spam Snarl with both of these Pokemon and win. That's literally it. The last Pokemon can be Galarian, Zapdos, or Politoed, depending on your need. So yeah, that's how you beat the Mian Shao Calyrex lead. Versus Indeedee plus Calyrex, it's even, excuse me, my throat's dry. It's even safer. You lead off Tapu Bulu plus Incineroar, and what that does is it makes it so you get your terrain up versus the zero speed Indeedee, which means Incineroar can now fake out the Indeedee, and then you click Snarl with your Tapu Bulu, lowering the special attack of both Pokemon, or you can also just go for a Horn Leech in the Indeedee and probably come close to getting a one shot. And at that point, you just spam Snarl. It's super free versus Indeedee Calyrex. So yeah, what would have been one of the worst matchups becomes one of the easiest matchups for this team. Versus things like Groudon, that one, it's pretty much always going to be a really tough decision as to whether or not you bring Duskmane or not, or if you bring Incineroar or not. Groudon's a little bit tough, but Tapu Bulu, Politoed, Kingdra is always going to be really good for that matchup. The last Pokemon is really tough. You could bring Necrozma Dust main, and that's, you know, intuitive. It's you restricted. But it's going to be one of those rare matchups where you might think to yourself, okay, Incineroar is really good here. And it just depends on the opponent's side of the field. Like if you're playing like a best of three and you know they have White Herb, don't even bother with Incineroar a lot of the time. Go ahead and just go for the KOs with like Politoed, Kingdra, and bring Necrozma in the back. Most of the time, that's safe. Incineroar is also just really good for the matchup because it helps beat the Venusaur more reliably because of your safety goggles. So yeah, Galarian Zapdos is also very tempting on that lead, or on that combination, because it's once again a Pokemon that beats Groudon and, you know, opposing Incineroar and Venusaur very easily. So that one's kind of rough. You kind of have to make some smart decisions. It's not necessarily an auto win or an auto loss. It's just a very tough matchup to explain because even I'm still trying to kind of get it sorted out. In all honesty, I haven't faced too many Groudon yet, but it's been, you know, a fine matchup. It's been okay. I just have to think a lot. I usually win that. Versus like Trick Room Calyrex, what you're going to want to do is pretty much always bring the Incineroar, Politoed, Necrozma Dust main, and Tapu Bulu. And the reason you do that is because Calyrex always has Torkoal next to it. Politoed helps you deal with a Calyrex that might have gotten out of control by, I don't know, getting off a Swords Dance or getting a Glacial Lance KO, thus activating Grimnay, which will allow you to not only get rid of like Sun from the Torkoal partner, but switch in on an ice move, resist it, hit it with a Scald, possibly get a burn and haze away stat boost. Beyond that, just cycling in the Incineroar on the Necrozma, or on the Calyrex, excuse me, on the Calyrex is super easy with this team. And once you get rid of the Torkoal, Necrozma Dust main pretty much always comes in and just cleans up for the rest of the team. So yeah, Kyogre is one of the most free matchups with this team. Kyogre is my favorite matchup with this team, in fact, because I think I mentioned this earlier. You always lead off Necrozma Bulu, and you just click Horn Leech into the freaking... you click Horn Leech into the Kyogre after they think they can KO you with Water Spout plus Hurricane, but they don't. they just straight up don't, because Tapu Bulu's cracked like that. You get a one shot and pretty much most of your health back. And if they decided to try to go for the taunt on your Trick Room, you block that with your Mental Herb and you just always get off the Trick Room. Another thing, if you're facing off versus Whimsicott Kyogre, which is another common way of running it for some reason this season, you don't have to worry about taunt or encore because of the Mental Herb. A lot of people don't realize this, but Mental Herb also blocks encore from having you reset your own Trick Room, so that's really nice. For the rest of that matchup, always bring the Incineroar to deal with opposing Czarina or Ferrothorn or Amoongus. I know you're facing a Kyogre and Incineroar is scary to bring, but trust me, the Kyogre goes down in a couple of turns, so it doesn't really matter. And your last Mon, it depends on the matchup, but I found Galarian Zapdos is really reliable because the Sash allows it to switch in on a lot of hits that would, you know, you wouldn't want to switch in with other Pokemon, and thus allowing you to pivot a little bit better. And a lot of opposing Kyogre teams also pack their own Incineroar in this metagame, so being able to prevent Intimidates with that thing is going to be really nice. Am I forgetting anything? I've covered Xerneas, I've covered Calyrex, I've covered Groudon, I've covered Zacian. I think I've covered pretty much every restricted that's super common. Palkia is one of the tougher matchups, I guess. That one's pretty even in my opinion. Tapu Bulu pretty much always shows up, and you have to make use of Tapu Bulu a lot in that matchup. Since it hard walls Palkia, Palkia does like nothing to it. Just keep clicking Horn Leech and play smart. So yeah, that's about all I'm going to say for this team right now. It's been super successful for me, and I've had a lot of fun using it. I'm really tired, and I'm going to end the video here. If you guys enjoyed, leave a like. If you have a lot of fun with the team, let me know. I wouldn't say this is the easiest team to pilot. I should have put this disclaimer at the beginning of the video. This is not like a low-level team. This is not a beginner team. This is a you-know-a-lot-about-Pokemon, and you want to use fun stuff team. I'd say this is like, what's the saying, or what's like the terminology? It is a low skill floor, high skill ceiling. At the lowest possible play, you're not going to get any results. At the highest possible play, you get results that are insane. Like, you can play out of so many tough situations. It has high potential, but if you're not playing it right, you're not going to do well. It's not like a Xerneas team, like standard Xerneas, where even someone very new at the game can get away with like clicking Geomancy and running away with the game if their opponent makes a bad play. This is a very, very, like, you have to play good team, if that makes sense. So yeah, a bit intimidating, but I'm sure you guys will have fun. Tapu Bulu propaganda forever. And yeah, have a nice night. See ya.